Our final award this evening will be presented by two distinguished senators who had the vision to set us all on a course toward greater nuclear security with their determination 20 years ago to write legislation that has helped secure and dismantle thousands of nuclear weapons and missiles and secure tons of weapons materials, Senators Dick Lugar and Sam Nunn.
Very few organizations have done more to create a safer world than NTI, and I'm honored to highlight NTI's decade of achievement with my longtime friend and my partner, Sam Nunn. Together, we are pleased to present an award named for the legislation we offered 20 years ago to a man who helped both craft and implement that legislation, Ash Carter. Back in 1991, Ash and his colleagues at Harvard had completed a very disturbing study on nuclear weapons in a disintegrating Soviet Union. He and Bill Perry, then at Stanford, came to Washington to brief Sam Nunn and me on the report and its extraordinary implications, namely that the United States should fund a comprehensive program to help the states of the former Soviet Union secure, safeguard, and eliminate the vast Soviet arsenal of weapons of mass destruction. 2 days later, Ash made another presentation to a bipartisan breakfast meeting of 16 senators. This presentation played an essential role in helping Sam and me secure prompt bipartisan support for our legislation. In subsequent years, the Nunn-Lugar program has deactivated 7,599 nuclear warheads, destroyed 2,366 missiles, 819,400 rounds of chemical munitions from the former Soviet arsenal. Building on the initial principles, Nunn-Lugar has now expanded to function worldwide, has undertaken several projects outside the former Soviet Union. While continuing with nuclear and chemical issues, Nunn-Lugar is also focusing strong attention on biological threats, particularly from Africa. The continent has a unique combination of naturally occurring dangerous diseases, poorly secured laboratories and research centers, where the pathogens are collected for study, and Islamic terrorist activity in the region's poorly governed spaces poses a threat. I traveled with the encouragement of Ash Carter and Bob Gates to Africa last year to highlight this threat and to encourage the Nunn-Lugar program to help increase security at these facilities. Ash Carter has gone from success to success in service in two administrations, a prestigious post at Harvard, co-author of 11 books and numerous awards. Sam and I, the United States government, and indeed all the citizens of the world, owe Ash Carter a debt of gratitude for his commitment to nuclear security. We are deeply honored to have the opportunity tonight, Ash, to present you with the NTI Nunn-Lugar Award in recognition of your historic and magnificent service.
Mr. Secretary, ambassadors, everyone here, so many friends, night is late. I just have a few things to say. The first is that it is and will forever be the privilege of my lifetime to have been a part of the history that Sam Nunn and Dick Lugar wrote and are still writing today. And second, to appreciate the magnitude of their accomplishment, you need to go back in time to a period when we thought that nuclear security inhered in the weapons themselves, and it was whether one side had this and the other side had that and so forth. And what Sam Nunn and Dick Lugar recognized as the Soviet Union disintegrated was that that things nuclear were fundamentally social, that it was a social system that supported the arsenals of the United States and the Soviet Union, and that we were witnessing for the first time in human history the disintegration of a social system that had in its possession nuclear weapons. And then they followed that thought through the end of the Soviet Union, and then to the recognition that when you understood that a state could disintegrate and that nuclear weapons could fall into the hands of others than those who built them and others than those for whom they were intended, that took you to the thought of non-state possessors of nuclear weapons. And when you understood fully the destructive power of nuclear weapons, that took you to other weapons of mass destruction. And they took us on all those journeys, and they weren't obvious at the time. It was very controversial. I think Senator Lugar adverted to this at the time, that we who had tried for half a century to drive the Soviet Union into the ground and into bankruptcy should be assisting them in any way, and particularly in respect of their nuclear arsenal. That was a counterintuitive thought that they had, and that they successfully convinced the governments of the United States and Russia and all the other successor states of the former Soviet Union was right. And that's a huge achievement. And that moving from the weapons themselves to the people who possess them was a change that lives with us now as we worry about terrorism and possession of weapons of mass destruction in the hands of terrorists, because there you have to start with the people even as you start with the stuff, which the previous awardee has so wonderfully done. And the last thing I wanted to say is this. You know, we all care about this so much, and we're so seized with this issue, and we're always so frustrated that not enough of our fellow citizens share our passion and our conviction about this eternal danger to humanity. And I console myself with the following thought, and on this note, wish you good night, that in a way, that's the way it ought to be. They ought to go home at night and sleep beneath the blanket of the safety and protection that these two historic gentlemen have provided, and they shouldn't have to worry. That's the way it ought to be. That's victory for our cause. And on that note, may you sleep beneath that blanket tonight. And thank you all very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.